payment of goods takes place with home country's currency. So the payment for the goods takes with the home country's currency. For example, we are doing the trade activities in India. The country's currency is rupees. Then we collect amount in the form of rupees. If the person who is in USA is doing the business, then he collects the money in the form of dollars. So the payment for the goods takes place with the home country's currencies in domestic trade. And transactions involves between producers, middlemen and consumers, as already I told you in the distribution chain. The transaction involves with the producers, middlemen and consumers. So the trade activity is completed between these persons, and wide variety of products are available. These are the different characteristics of the domestic trade. The first one is exchange of goods takes place within the country, and goods transported by using roadways and railways. Payment of goods takes place with home country's currency, and transactions involves between producers, middlemen and consumers, and there is a wide variety of products are available for the customers. So these are the characteristics of the domestic trade. Now we are going to learn about what is the significance of international trade, or what is the significance of foreign trade. Significance of international trade. Okay, so if it is necessary to do the international trade activities, what is the necessity with that we are doing international business activities is to be discussed here. As we know that international trade takes place beyond the boundaries of the nations or between the different countries. In the present era, the countries are dependent on one and another for their business purposes. Okay, so why there is a need arises for the international trade? What is the significance of international trade? Why the countries are following the international trade? Okay, the first one is natural resources. Many of the countries have the plenty of natural resources in their countries. Many of the countries, but not all the countries are producing, or not all the countries are having that such of natural resources in their country. In some countries, different kinds of natural resources are widely available. In some countries, those resources are very scarce. So here, if we are doing the international trade activities, where the natural resources are highly available, those resources are transferred to the place where those resources are scarce. Okay, so availability of the natural resources in some countries and those who are in scarce in other countries is became came together through international trade. The resources that are available in the one country, those are also enjoyed by the other country's person where the resources are very scarce. So international trade is fills the gap between the resource utilization. Okay, and next one is economic production activity. In some countries, certain products are produced very economically or very cheaply because they have the availability of raw materials, technical skills. Because of that reason, they may produce certain goods at very cheap cost. Okay, if those are available at lower prices, we have to compare. If we are producing such goods, how much cost we incur? How much price we are charging from the customer? Or otherwise, we are importing those goods to our country, then in what price we sell those to the customer? What is the benefit? We have to analyze that. For example, there is a product, if we are producing, the cost for that product is 50 rupees. And by adding some profit margin, we are selling those to the customer at the rupees of 55. But if you are importing those products which are widely available in certain countries, the product is available for 40 rupees and you may have the margin of 5 rupees and you sold those product at 45 rupees. Here what happens, if you are producing, there is a difference between 10 rupees, right? If you are producing, it leads to a price increase. But if you are importing those goods and you sell that, then the price may decrease up to certain level. So to get the advantage of these activities, the entrepreneur trade will play a prominent role. We are importing certain goods that are cheaply available in some countries to meet our needs in our country. Okay, and next one is climatic conditions. The climatic conditions also influence the international trade, because some of the climates in some countries is not favorable for producing certain things. For example, in Cuba, the sugar is widely available because of their climatic conditions. In Egypt, the cotton is widely available because of their climatic conditions. So the trade between these two countries, Cuba and Egypt countries, will make the use of sugar and cotton in both the countries. So because of this, the international trade will occur. And sharing of knowledge, culture and ideas. International trade increases the sharing of knowledge, culture and ideas between different countries. Okay, and next one is it decreases the price for the products. It decreases the price for the products. As already I told you, in the economic production activity, if those goods are available at cheaper price in other countries, better we are import those goods to our country, right? So it decreases the price for the products. And in this era, every country or any country is dependent upon other countries for their resources or for their some kind of products. So they are sharing their ideas, culture and knowledge between them. They are formed as a associations, trading associations, and they are doing the, just like it becomes like all the world is treated as an entire market for the business persons in today's scenario. Right. So in this way, the international trade have the significant position in the country's economy because of the availability of the natural resources, because of the production, economic in the production activities, climatic conditions, and sharing knowledge, culture, and it decreases the price for the product. In these elements, it has a significant place in the development of the economy.